Hey guys, welcome back to Painting with Peety. This is the fourth episode, the official episode, I should say, and we're doing the last pie. So today we're going to do a pecan pie. Pecan, whatever. You know what I'm talking about. But anyway, let me introduce you to some of these colors. We got a lot. We got some gold that represent the crust. We got this bronzy looking color that's going to represent some pecans, pecans, whatever. Got another dark bronzy looking color that's going to represent the same. We got some crust. We got some other bronzy color that's lighter than the others. And of course, you can't have a pie without a light looking color. And then we got clear. So what we're gonna do today is something different. We're gonna do something called a puddle pour. And what a puddle pour is you're just pouring onto the canvas in a certain area with all the different colors. And then doing something, moving around, see what happens. In this case, we're gonna do a little bit something different, make the technique. It'll come out good, basically, is what I'm trying to say. So without further ado, I'm gonna keep on talking. Let's keep it moving. I'm gonna start out with some crust. We'll start right in the middle of the canvas. Start out with some crust. Oh, and if you didn't notice, I got tired of doing the flat canvases, so I decided to do a stretch canvas. Now, what a stretch canvas is compared to one of the flat canvas, it's fairly self-explanatory. It's just a canvas that's stretched around some wood, a wood frame. That's really all it is. So, yeah. So far, so good, guys. I think I'm going to do something different. Put that right there. Everybody always wants to pour in the middle of each individual circle. I like to sort of go against the grain, I guess you could say. A little bit of, looks like a snowman a little bit. Anyway. Alright, let's finish this baby up and get to moving it around. Then I have another technique after I finish doing this pour that's really going to give me some razzle dazzle, you can say. You hear the beats in the background, I make those. So if you're an artist or something of that nature, check it out and see what you can do for me. Just go to the so far so good. Just starting to look pretty decent. Be creative. Hopefully we're making a day, a great day. Hopefully you're having a great day without us. But either way, I hope it's great. Got some really cool stuff coming. So got some brand new techniques I want to show y'all in the future. Put some more crust. And if you have any other ideas of what you think might make this show a little better, feel free to email me at paintingwithpeety@gmail.com. And, take it away right there to the celebration. Let's build this around a little bit before I put the extra spice on there. It's going to give it that razzle dazzle. Now, let's do this clear. Look at that. That will bring that paint to life. It's amazing. Alright, now I'd like to stand up. Sorry for all the noise. And then we'll get to move this one right now. So I'm not really sorry for how dirty my workspace is. I like to see the progress that I've made over the time. So it's always, I clean it from time to time. But I really don't like to look good. It's all the good ideas from it. Anyway. See what we got going on here. Of course, you know we're gonna torch it. We're gonna torch it. Look at that. That was nice. Let's torch it. Like I always say, torching is to get all the air bubbles out. It also helps to create seals. So, really cool thing to do there. Edges, make sure you put the edges of your hand in as well, because those have burst. So, yeah. So I'm gonna start to see some cells created. They're starting to form. So far so good, guys, and we'll be back.